Welcome back to another Aleshop video. Today we're talking about a button that seems helpful but can actually hold you back. AutoSet. If you're just starting out with an oscilloscope, AutoSet looks like an easy solution. Press a button and boom, you have your waveform on screen. But there's a catch. It often gives you a false sense of control. And worse, it doesn't always work. In this video, we'll show you what AutoSet really does and how to find the signal properly using the controls yourself. Let's get started. What does AutoSet actually do? When you press AutoSet, the scope tries to detect the signal and adjust the vertical scale, horizontal time base and trigger level automatically. Sounds great, but there's the issue. It assumes a repetitive clean signal. It might set the wrong voltage or time range, and it often fails to trigger properly. Let's see that in action. Here we got a short pulse signal, very basic. When we press AutoSet, you can see this basic signal is easily captured by the AutoSet function. In this scenario, a very basic signal can easily be recognized with AutoSet. But let's test with a more complex signal. When we press AutoSet, you can see it doesn't trigger. The time base is way too zoomed in. With AutoSet, it's not really possible to get a useful waveform on screen for this specific signal. Now let's reset and learn how to use your oscilloscope properly by setting it manually. Before we go into detail, I'll first give you a brief overview of the controls we'll be using. Then we'll go through them step by step. We're using three main settings on the oscilloscope. The vertical scale, this is the voltage per division. The horizontal scale, this is the time per division. And the trigger setting. This determines the specific point in the waveform that initiates the display of the signal on the screen. First, adjust the vertical scale, volts per division. It controls how much voltage is shown per square on the screen. In this case, we start with a high value, like 5 volts per division. Then we lower it step by step to zoom in on your signal. This gives you a clearer view of the waveform. For fine tuning, press the knob to switch between coarse and fine adjustment. Watch out for the offset. If an incorrect offset is set on the scope, it might be hard to find the signal. Offset can be reset to 0 by pressing the position knob. Next, set the horizontal scale, time per division. This controls how much time each square represents. Use microseconds or milliseconds depending on your signal. Faster signals need smaller time values. Slower signals need larger ones. This helps stretch or compress the signal in time. Now set the trigger level. We are using edge triggering. That means the oscilloscope starts drawing when the signal crosses a certain voltage. We set the trigger to rising edge. There are many trigger types, but for now we'll keep it simple. Triggering can be tricky, especially for beginners. With adjusting the trigger level, I can find the highest point on the signal and therefore can trigger easily and get a clear waveform on screen. As you can see, a signal which was hard to capture with AutoSet can be shown by manually setting vertical scale, horizontal scale and the trigger level. AutoSet might be quick and simple compared to manual setup. But the more you set up the parameters manually, the easier it becomes. after a while, controlling an oscilloscope will be as easy as using the mouse on your PC. But if you keep using AutoSet mainly, you will never become fluent in the manual way. So, don't use AutoSet and learn to search for signals manually. It takes a little practice, but once you get the hang of it, you'll read any waveform with confidence. Elishop also has a knowledge center filled with expert written articles on electronics, offering comparison, tips and guides, like choosing the right oscilloscope probe for your measurement task. Be sure to check it out. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.